Well, it's starting to rain out there. No trials for me this afternoon, so but I've got another idea. Hey Groovers, I like to start every day with some physical activity in the morning. A mountain bike ride is best. Often, the first thing I do, I'll take the dog for a walk or a run. Great just to get that physical activity going in the morning. Doesn't have to be anything terribly strenuous, it can just be pretty moderate. Might only be 10 or 15 minutes long, but it just really helps get your metabolism going.
I get asked a lot what stretching and flexibility exercises I do for mountain biking. So I'm going to show you just one of the exercises that I somehow enjoy, and I think you will too, especially when you find out how important it is for your mountain biking, how it can improve your mountain biking.
You know, get those good chemicals running through your body. It really helps start your day in the best way.
To be honest, I'm not a very flexible guy and I'm not very disciplined when it comes to doing flexibility exercises, and I mean, to be honest, that's just a bit of an excuse really. I just haven't, you know, put the priority on flexibility that I should. And so I'm probably like a lot of mountain bikers, you know, we're fairly inflexible and we need to get more flexible and really help with our movement on the bike. But the one thing that really saves me is my hip flexibility, and I think I probably got it from a young age playing a lot of Lego and just carried that through, and of course I still play Lego today. You know, you might be asking, why is hip flexion or hip flexibility so important? Well, so you don't have to bend your back. The more you can use your hips, then the less you need to bend your back. Now, that's worth repeating. The more you can use the hips, the more flexible you are with your hips, the less you need to bend your back and load your back up when you're mountain biking. With good hip flexion, you can be far more dynamic on the bike and keep control. You can blast along the trail with far greater ease and fun because you have the ability to move about and constantly, you know, you're constantly manipulating your position to maintain your balance and control, often getting nice and low and soaking up the bike. With good hip flexion and hip hinging, as I like to call it, it's far easier to keep your core engaged, to support your upper body in balance on and off the saddle. See, when your hip flexion is poor, your hips only go so far, and then you start bending through the waist and your back, unbalancing your core muscles and loading up your back. You've got to brace yourself to the handlebar just to hold yourself on the bike. And most of us take that habit all over the trail. We're either leaning on the bar or pulling back on the bar, up climbs, down descents, white knuckled because you're wrestling the bike, wrestling with the handlebar. What's that do? Well, that kills your form, it kills your efficiency, your fun, and your skill. Here's a simple exercise that can help improve your hip flexibility, the pigeon pose. There's a link on screen or maybe down below to a really good video that shows you the steps to do the pigeon pose, and the lady also gives some cheats for those of us that are starting out or a bit less flexible to help us do it with greater ease. So I encourage you to get warmed up and give the pigeon pose a go. Remember, the more you use your hips, the less you need to bend through your back, and that's a good thing. So let me know the difference that the pigeon pose makes to your mountain biking. I always get a certain amount of satisfaction out of doing the pigeon pose because I know how good it is for me and how better it makes me on the bike.